What's your favourite Tobo snack? What do we eat quite a lot? We get a lot of fan food, which is weird, which people say you shouldn't eat, but at 3 o'clock in the morning, when you're on your way to like Tallahassee, and you're a bit wrecked, you like, eat some cupcakes that are beaten with your own face on them.
So you were born in 1975?
No.
You know Liz Truss was born in 1975? And DJ Khaled, so you're in good company.
I was born in the 80s. Yeah, you were born in 1989, and I'm still young and relevant.
Sure.
On the wall,
I found a fan letter in my pocket when I put my jacket on today.
Okay, nice. Oh, what, lovely,
nice handwriting.
Lovely
as well.
Handwriting, yeah.
It might be hate mail, we haven't found
okay,
it.
Okay, you haven't got to the end yet.
Exactly.
But
with Matt Healy from the 1975.
It's actually Matty if we're going to do it properly.
Okay, Matty, sorry. This is Matty from 1975. Sorry, the 1975. And just.
There was a sign that said, let's get anal.
Can you believe that? Let's get anal. I will not do anal with somebody who has such a slender grasp on grammar. I will not. I refuse it.
He's not getting in his cage.
That sounds like I'm
crate, not cage.
He's got some enormous big Taj Mahal-esque kind of cage. You could fit like 50 dogs in. And now he's acting like I'm trying to cram him into a box.
Get in the glove box.
I'm like, Alan, don't make me say get in the cage. Because, you know, that's not what our relationship's like.
Get in the cage.
Get in the cage, Alan. But he's just not doing, he just thinks he's the boss. And he kind of is, because I'm like a tired single mother who gets back up to work and I'm like, just eat all of the roast dinner, I don't mind.
Yeah, you just have one thing.
Yeah, exactly. You can sleep in my bed.
If you had 1 hour left to live, what would you do?
Probably kill someone.
Who?
I don't know.
Just random?
You want to do that question? You want to do that question properly? Yes. Like, what would you do, though?
Yeah.
So you know that it's the end of the world. I don't know.
Not end of the world. Like, you only have an hour left.
Yeah. Oh, I have an hour left. Right, I wouldn't kill anybody. I think I'm the end of the world. I can't believe I said that so quickly as well.
I'm gonna forget your lyrics. Oh my God, I've asked for an auto cue like 3 times and the band have said no. We're not letting you, because then point you'll be asking for a bed or something.
Yeah,
you'll just be lying on your back.
Can I FaceTime in? Can I do it from home?
But yeah, I do need an auto cue because I can never remember the lyrics. And then people at the front turn up and they don't know them, but they sing as if they do. So I just watch them
and they start
singing the wrong ones. And I'm going, oh, I smell like chocolate or whatever, the wrong song.
Yeah, but you can't get mad at them getting your lyrics wrong. You wrote them.
Don't get in my face and sing the wrong lyrics if you're expecting me to sing.
You know,
if you were trying to count and I got up in your face and went, 16, 15, you'd be like, stop it.
Maybe because it's so far away and obviously you don't go there very often, the fans, they're just absolutely crazy. They're just...
Hey!
He didn't see
easily it. Distracted. Just really
saw a lot of boobs in Australia.
We got chased out of a house for being gay. In us, well, I'm not, but like, that's not the point.
If you vote no, you're not allowed to go home, you know that? You have to stay here in Denmark.
Which I really would not mind. I mean, look at your face. You're a beautiful man. I can stay here with you. Not too bothered.
Yeah, because
Brexit.
I'm married.
You're married?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
To a girl?
Yeah.
Ah, lucky woman.
But you're not a man before you tried a man.
That is very true.
I want to talk about the title of your album. Who did you write that about? Is it the drum player?
It's the drummer. I always say it was a note that I left on his bed. I should have written it about you.
If we do this interview like 4 minutes more, we fall in love and I can't make that happen.
Okay. It's the eyes though. It's the dark hair, blue eyes. That's what people in my country are a big sucker for.
I love you.
Thinking this through. Thinking this through, it's like one. Well, I got it, found it, just thinking. Thinking this through.
The show goes out on the internet. I've seen a lot of people talking about my relationship with the camera woman. That is a bloke. That is a bloke, okay?
Right, this one is a crown shaped like a crown. Oh no! Oh no, no, no!
What is it?
It's mint chocolate! No! Oh, I hate mint chocolate, you agree with me. What is the point? Just brush your teeth and have some chocolate. Fucking hell. This one is.
Try this cone.
Is a cup. George's eating a cone with nuts on it. Yeah, very clever, very funny. Everyone think that's funny. Pretending to light it. Oh, it's got like caramel in it. Out of 10, what do you think?
That's pretty good, that's like fair rushing.
What do you think out of 10?
7.
7 out of 10 for the cone. I'm gonna try this cup with white chocolate in it. Oh no.
Intense,
well, I don't really like posh chocolate, to be honest with you.
For the record, we spent 20 minutes last night lurking your Instagram to make sure that you're not vegan.
Really? I'm not vegan. I'm not even vegetarian. I wish I could be. I love Morrissey. I don't. Yeah, it's alright. It's like 5 out of 10. But it's posh chocolate.
What's that?
That's not anything, mate. You've tried that one. What's this one? This is just a little teddy bear. I like that.
That's just chocolate.
I like that one. That's just chocolate. That'll do. 10 out of 10. Why not?
I feel sick after chocolate. That cone thing.
And this one. It's one of them pineapple things from New Zealand. I like these pineapple chunks.
We are.
7 out of 10. 7 out of 10. Alright, good. That's alright.
I'm just shitting.
Hate it. Mint chocolate.
That tastes a bit like vomit.
Oh, it does a bit. Okay, game over, I suppose. The winner
I
is.
Hope that wasn't too
what's the winner?
The cone.
The cone's the winner.
This one. Always the winner.
There's a lot of heavy Twitter rumours that you guys might be working with Taylor Swift. Can you say anything about that?
Oh, well, no, we're not. We'd love to. Love to work with Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
Love Taylor Swift. Think she's one of the best songwriters. Yeah, no, it's not. There's no... We haven't done that. We'd love to, though, wouldn't you? Wouldn't we?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
Yes,
probably
please,
watching George right says. Now, actually. So it's probably going to happen.
Probably sat there just watching, you know, just watching this pining for a feature.
It's been a year since we've had this chat.
I know, and I've felt every second of that year. How are you? Are you all right?
What, every second missing me or every second of pain from the interview?
Oh, no, a bit of both. A bit of both. No, I have missed you, though.
I've missed you, like, a lot.
All right.
I've missed you more, though, to be honest.
Thanks. So sweet.
Okay. All right. Okay, sweet.
Andy, what happened?
I don't know what happened, dude. I think so. That is what happened. You know, I love Tokyo so much. You guys are so fucking funny.
Let me just show you, by the way. Average height man. Wait. Average height man, Matty. Okay? He's massive. Lynn, no, actually quite a tall woman. Still not as tall as Matty. You see?
Oh, see. Protein shake all over my fuck
off. Oh, probably underrated, but I don't. I'm not very good with multivitamins. Ever since I did, I'd never had them before. And my tour manager was like, "Have some of these, that make you feel better." And I hadn't had breakfast. And I was on live radio. And you know, if you eat them without food, they make you really sick. I wasn't aware of that. Threw up all over live Australian radio after multivitamins, and the taste of it has kind of scarred my life. So I really don't like multivitamins. I like to go hard, though, if I'm going to try something for the first time. It's like when I went to South by Southwest, do you remember? And Nick, who was our radio guy, I asked him for something like Pro Plus, and he gave me 3 Adderall, right? I'd never had, didn't know what this was. So he held them out, so I just necked them. I didn't sleep for 4 days. It was wild. 8 shows with no sleep. That was a trip. I fucking loved that week. It was so good. But like, yeah, America, you can really get some crazy shit over here.
So for example, the city, if you could fall in love in any city, what would it be and why?
It's gotta be London. London is, I think, my favorite city in the world.
Money, have you ever taken drugs?
Yes.
Chocolate, do you have a problem with authority?
Yes.
Sex, have you ever been with someone who already had a boyfriend, girlfriend?
Yes.
Talk, do you know someone who talks a lot of bullshit and doesn't stop?
Me.
Hard out, do you have feelings for someone and wish they were reciprocated?
Yes.
Ooh, settle down, have you ever had someone lead you on?
Yes.
Robbers, have you ever been hurt by someone over and over and kept giving them second chances?
No.
Smart. Girls, have you ever been with someone who wasn't what you needed?
Yes.
She way out. Have you ever been with someone who is way out of your league?
It's got nothing to do with that, and yes.
Menswear, do you hate weddings?
No, I love weddings. It's a unification of two people, isn't it? It's a good thing, I think, weddings.
Pressure. Have you ever lied to someone because of the pressure in a social situation?
Yes.
Is there somebody who can watch you? Do you feel like you are responsible for a person who you love a lot?
Very much so, as should everybody.
Me, which is one of my favorite songs. Have you done anything which had bad consequences and hurt you or the other people?
Of course I have.
You want to elaborate?
Not really.
Good.
Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
Moral ambiguity to that one, but have you fucking eaten it? I eat it with my gay friends. Like, we're cool. We're all cool with that chicken. So good. Yeah. Chick-fil-A, like, honestly, this is gonna sound like kind of childish, like, especially because you guys just have things, then you go, right, commercialize it. Like, you guys have done that with weed, right? So you go to certain parts of America and there's like weed stores, right? It's fucking amazing. It's amazing. It's crazy. Like, in the UK, that would just never ever happen. But I think as soon as you see where the money is, we'll have some of that. Not in a bad way, I like it.
Underrated. I'm circumcised. Never done me any issues. Never done me any problems. I mean, what are you going to ask me a question? I'm not going to, like, not everyone's like, why are you saying that you're circumcised? Why say I'm not circumcised? We're talking about circumcision. You've either got two images in your head. Neither are good. Both are a penis. Well, any party, nightmare, overrated. Get me out of there. Thanks very much. See you later. I'm going home. Especially not surprise. What if I've got, like, an headache? Overrated, because why is he a bunny? What's that about? I don't know why it's a rabbit. I don't know why eggs are knocking around. It's like this really confused set of visual ideas. A rabbit who does eggs, who's also a bit like a fairy that knows Jesus. It's like...
George is eye-fucking the camera, therefore eye-fucking me. I'm not complaining.
You can't do that.
I wasn't doing that.
Don't do that. Why? I wasn't aware of that.
Who are you eye-fucking?
I'm...
George. You're the quiet one. Here's the one that can get away with that.
Don't you dare.
When do I ever look down a camera? Who does that in an interview? What's up?
Face off and start playing arenas on our first album or something like that.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. It's not very rock and roll, is it?
That's no good sugar in it.
We do think about that, but...
You say that to me. Can you imagine?
any other social situation where you could shout that at someone's face?
And the whole thing
if you were stood in a queue next to someone, if you thought that at the shops and you're in a queue,
or even if it was, even if it,
fuck me, like that. Can you imagine that? You're not allowed to do that.
A band of
excuse me, do you know what time? Oh my God, aren't you Matthew?
Yes, it's me.
Where are you going?
I'm going home.
Oh, do you have room for one more?
What, in my, yeah, come on, let's go home.
Maybe we should kiss. That was Matthew from 1975. Thank you very much.
Oh my God.
Yes. So thank you for the interview.
I can't believe we kissed. Like smoking, for example, I'd love to give up smoking. I would love it. It would be so good. But it punctuates my day. It's, you know, you do this, you finish, you have a cigarette, you get in the car, you have a cigarette, you get out of the car, you have a cigarette, do this song, have a cigarette.
Tequila sunrise. Have you even had one of those?
No. What would it be?
Well, I'd like to say red wine, but we're definitely not highbrow enough to be a good Malbec.
Not enough tannin.
Cranberry juice? Because it's a bit sweet, but then once you get through the sweetness, you realise it's actually a bit shit.
Good for urinary infections.
And it stops you from getting thrush. That's the opposite of us. It's not cranberry juice or anything.
Oh, God. You said you're the opposite of not getting thrush.
How did Pitbull make me feel? The artist.
You always talk about Pitbull.
I don't. Everyone asked me about it. I think I must have slagged him off once. I mean, what is he?
You referenced him as like...
He looks like Mr. Jones. Do you remember Mr. Jones, the science teacher? I saw him lift crazy little Mike above his head once. I'd like to see Pitbull lift someone above his head.
What's Pitbull doing with little Mike?
Pitbull is... What is he? He's like a singer. What do I think about him? Shit.
Is he on Sony in Australia?
Fucking no.
Is that the end of the interview?
He is.
He is. Is he on the label? Oh, you're not shit. You just.
You ever heard of the Yorkshire Ripper?
Yeah, I know the Yorkshire Ripper. You pronounce it slightly differently.
Sorry, Yorkshire Ripper.
Yorkshire.
Yorkshire.
Yeah.
The Ripper killed his first victim. That was the.
Did he?
Yeah. 1975.
What a knob.
So hold on a second. Let me just shout at my dog. Ah! I've got you loads of toys, you don't need to chew that. So